Hi everyone, I am Ishmeet and I'm back here today with you with the topic of procurement management. We will try to understand what procurement management is and how it is useful in the project management process. Procurement management is the process of evaluation, selection, and creation of contracts. And it also manages the relationship of the company with the suppliers and the business partners. So basically, procurement management forms the practice that ensures the efficient working of the organization. It consists of activities for obtaining goods and services from other parties, which also includes receiving small essentials to heavy equipment, consulting services, and testing. Procurement management will not only save your resources, money, and time, but will also be responsible for the proper and smooth functioning of the company. For us to fully utilize the benefits of procurement management, we shall understand the various key steps involved in it. Let's see what those are. Specification and planning, identifying and selecting suppliers, proposal requesting, negotiating and contracting, control and delivery, and lastly, measurement and analysis. In specification and planning, first, the company should mention the requirements of the equipment or services from the supplier beforehand with a procurement plan. There should be a proper, detailed list of essentials that will be required that will help in estimating the budget. Next, in identifying and selecting, the suppliers should be selected properly after a comparative analysis of the advantages and disadvantages or the pros and cons of various other suppliers. The focus should be that the supplier should be able to deliver the required materials on time and should be capable to meet the demands of the company. The criteria to identify a potential vendor are the time of the delivery, cost, safety, service, and support. Also, environmental responsibility and the quality of the product being supplied. After selecting the suppliers on the basis of the criteria we fixed, the requests for the services are done, and accordingly, the negotiations are made. The negotiation depends on the trust and dependability of the suppliers. The requirement of the services should be communicated properly by stating the deadline of the delivery, details about the payment, and the number of products required so as to avoid any confusions or issues that will be faced after receiving the services. When everything has been stated and worked upon properly, only then the contract should be signed. After signing the contract, the organization's purchasing department should look into the payment matters, the delivery of services, and other issues that might be related to it. The meeting with vendors should be done on a regular basis. Tracking of the delivery should be done carefully, and the checking of the quality of the products and services for the proper procurement process should also be carried out. It may also happen that the contract might need some changes, which is very much possible according to the situation and the need. In the last step, the procurement process must be analyzed properly by keeping some important indicators in mind, which will help in checking the efficiency, the cost, the quality, the speed, and the progress towards the success of the entire process. Identification of the improvements and changes that have been made is carried out. This helps in securing future projects. I'm sure you already understand why there is a need of a separate management process for these activities, but let me list it down for you. The importance of procurement management is maintaining a better relationship with the suppliers and also keeping everything organized at every step that is necessary for the success of any company. In this advanced technological era, the digital procurement process is gaining much popularity. This procurement management helps in reducing errors and also helps in speedy working to increase the efficiency of the organization. How do you think procurement management is adding to your project? Let us know in the comments below. There are several other benefits to procurement management. These are cost and time in the process will be reduced. Expectations will be fewer. The requests, rules, and regulations can be improved. There will be a better supply chain management. Productivity can also be increased. The negotiations of contracts with potential suppliers can be even better at lower prices. There are roles and responsibilities in procurement management which are necessary to help the process flow smoothly and achieve what we seek through this process. For example, procurement managers try to get quality products at the lowest cost possible from the suppliers and also maintain that business relationship. It also has to look after the departments of purchasing products and services and accounting, among others. Some roles in procurement management are that of procurement analyst, procurement specialist, sourcing manager, procurement buyer, purchasing agent, and purchasing manager. The people in this role can achieve efficiency through the five rights of procurement management. These are right quality, right quantity, right place, right time, and right price. But can you be a procurement manager? Do you think you have the skills? Check for yourself as I list down five most important skills to be a procurement manager. The first is relationship management, because you are primarily playing the role of maintaining relationships between the company and the supplier and other business partners. The next is strong negotiation skills, proper management of time, analytic thinking for supervising the various steps that we discussed previously, and taking every criteria into consideration. And lastly, being change positive, because a lot of changes can be expected throughout the process. If you're interested to study more about procurement management or anything related to project management, I will leave the link for a book in the description called Love, Empathy and Project Management. I hope that this video was informative and you learned something by the end of it. For more such videos, check out the Pixel Labs YouTube channel. Thank you.